Hello.
Hi. Are you single?
Do you know what all of this made of? It's made of all of the ingredients one you need.
We don't worship the same God. I'm just going to explain it. So yeah, Allah means God, right? If you translate it, it means God. If we worship the same God, why is it that we never address God as Allah? And some will say, well, it's a different language. But God has many names. It's Yahweh, Abba, Allah, but never Allah. And Jesus wasn't just the Son of God and he wasn't a prophet. Yes, Jesus is the Son of God, but he came as God in the flesh to die for our sins. Reason why we pray in Jesus' name. It's the Holy Trinity 3-in-1. It's God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. And if you can't acknowledge that Jesus is God and that he died on the cross for our sins, then we can't be saved. You are only saved by accepting Jesus as Lord and Savior and confessing and knowing that he died on the cross for our sins and rose from the dead 3 days later. Plus, it's a relationship with God. It's strictly by faith and having faith in God and allowing him to work in our lives, but we also have to diligently seek him by being in our word. And being in our word builds our relationship with God and we grow closer to him. You can know who Jesus is today too.
Ah, geez, where do I start? Well, I was born into a satanic family. Both of my parents were drug addicts. At one point, I was homeless. I lived in 33 different places. I was extremely physically abused. I was suicidal, and I decided to leave the house at only 10 years old because I thought I was gonna kill myself or my stepdad, and I probably would have. But when I was 7 years old, I heard the voice of God speak to me, and he said, "Pray for your mom." Long story short, it literally saved my life. What happened after that. The years go on, I was put into foster care. I lived in a basement cellar and a lot of other illegal situations. It was terrible. One night, because they didn't have enough rooms for us, they put us in jail because that's what they do in foster care. And that night, I cried out to God and he made himself real to me. But this is only the beginning, so watch the next video. Testimony part two, let's go. Now, fair warning, it gets really crazy from here, so religious spirits, prepare yourselves.
I'm just kidding.
So I didn't have a family, right? I didn't have anything, anyone. Everything I had was taken from me. I was abused even while I was in foster care, moving constantly, no order, no structure. Then I'm in jail, I'm starving. I'm literally hungry and trapped in a cell for no reason at all, for nothing I ever did. I cry out to God, he makes himself real to me, and over a year's time, he began showing me miracles. But I still didn't have a relationship with God, because God was after my heart. And believing in God is not the same thing as trusting God. God wants us to have a relationship with him, not just believe that he exists. Now this is the part where I said I was gonna get a little crazy. And remember, I don't get to choose my story. A girl walked past me in high school, and the Holy Spirit reached out and touched me, and convicted me of sin when she walked past me. I finally understood that repentance was turning away from doing things my own way because I was created for love and God is love and I was created to let God take control of my life. So I gave my life to Jesus in my bedroom by myself, nobody having led me to Jesus but Jesus himself. And if you missed the last videos, you should go watch them. Within 6 months of being saved, I was adopted at 16 years old by a man who was elderly and who wasn't even a foster parent. Y'all don't realize how many statistics that blows out of the water. After 4 years old, you have less than a 4% chance of getting adopted out of foster care. Well, he adopted me and my dad became my best friend. The scripture says that God sets the lonely in families. My dad gave his life to Jesus at 76 years old and he began telling everybody about Jesus.
I'm not gonna lie. The enemy had me there for a while, but not anymore. I know who God puts that I am. Game over.
Yeah, walk in the lab like I was Dexter.
Hold up.
Why didn't you tell me? Well, because I wanted us to fail.
Obviously, I didn't.
Maybe the guys can help me out with this one because I'm honestly so confused. A lot of guys, this is what I noticed, a lot of guys don't even like the fact that you are a woman of God. They like the fact that you consider yourself a church girl. So they want a girl who's a good girl but also a bad girl. Yeah, mm-hmm. They want a girl who's like of the world but also calls himself a Christian. Mm-hmm. I don't understand that. But then when I tell them, no, like, I'm called to be set apart. Like, I'm not called to be of the world. Like, I, like, pray before every decision that I make. Like, I'm waiting till marriage to have sex. Mm-hmm. They're like, oh, so you're really religious? Oh, you mean I'm not lukewarm? Oh, got it. Like, you mean that, like, just the Christian title means more than me than, like, the average Joe? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm that girl. Mm-hmm. Yup, that's me. That's why it's super important to make sure you're equally yoked with someone, ladies.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise is what I do. When I wanna be close to you.
No. Mm-mm. Don't do that. Not in my car. Where the gospel music at?
You know, I just love you, Lord. Yeah, I love you. I just love you.
So, Pops, the lady was looking at me like I'm crazy, like I'm not speaking to you. She said, oh, you're always talking to yourself. And I said, no, I'm talking to God.
Satan can't curse you. But he understands that life and death is in your tongue. So his entire strategy is to get you to curse you. And he does that by planting thoughts in your mind and convincing you to say them out your mouth. And as soon as you say that thought from Satan out your mouth, he didn't curse you, you cursed you. No one ever likes me. You said that, not God. I guess I just wasn't made to be rich. You said that, not God. Man, doors just don't open for me. God didn't say that either. Man, my kids aren't going to become anything. The Bible says that there's people that they tear their life down with their words.
Don't stop. Don't stop praying. Don't stop believing. Don't stop having faith. Don't stop praying before you eat. Don't stop praying before you get on the airplane. Don't stop praying before you go to bed. Don't stop praying in public. Don't stop worshiping in public. Don't stop thanking God every single second. Don't stop relying on God. Don't stop reading your Bible. Don't stop glorifying God. Don't stop spreading the gospel. Don't stop doing what you're doing when it comes to walking in God's purpose and plan for your life. No matter how many people make fun of you, no matter how many people just don't understand it, don't stop. Don't stop for anyone. I know it's gonna get hard. I know society's gonna tell you, like, what are you doing? Like, God's not real. God's like this. Like, you can still do this and you can still do that. Don't stop. Don't stop having faith. Don't stop being a light in your family. Don't stop praying over your mom, your dad. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't.